Bence şık ya. Önemli bari.
Right. Once again, want to give all praises to Yahawa, Baasham, Yahushai, Baasham, Raka, Kodash. Double honors to the apostles, great millstone that rule well. Peace and blessings to the elect, the nation of Israelite. These are brothers from the Trinidad GMS camp. Come to do a little street preaching. Right today. On way, basically, the young call of Babylon and the society demise. And the uplifting of the nation of Israel. Right? Mm-hmm. Yeah, by the time I was speaking, brother, I got something seeing that the so-called white man falling day by day. All the hell is going through. All the trouble, all the torture, rape, robbery, and murder that he put us through as a nation. We're going to come to an end very soon. Right? Right, this is Isaiah chapter 14, verse 1. And it says, "For the Lord will have mercy on Jacob, and will yet choose Israel, and set them in their own land."
Right? So the scripture says the Lord will have mercy on Jacob, and he will choose Israel.
Right.
Because you're now stating there that all the affliction we're going through right now is soon going to end. So the scripture says, the Lord will not choose Israel. Well, have mercy on Jacob and choose Israel. Right?
Right. It says, "And the strangers shall be joined with them, and they shall cleave to the house of Jacob. And the people shall take them and bring them to their place. And the house of Israel shall possess them in the land of Yahweh for servants and handmaids."
Right, these strangers, we have all these other nations, right? They say we're going to take them captive, right?
Yeah, it says, "And the strangers shall be joined with them, and they shall cleave to the house of Jacob."
Yeah, so like, that strangers speaking about the foreigners, the Israelite foreigners, right? They shall be joined with Israel, right? They will come back to the true identity, right?
It says, "And the people shall take them and bring them to their place, and the house of Israel shall possess them in the land of Yahweh for servants and handmaids, and they shall take them captives, whose captives they were, and they shall rule over the oppressors."
They shall rule over the oppressors. And who are we oppressors? Right now, currently. So-called white man. Right, the white name is Edomite. Biblical name is Edom. Right? True name is Edom, Esau. Right? So we're going to bring them back into captivity. We're going to bring them into captivity the same way they have us in captivity right now.
That's right.
Right?
This is Lamentations chapter 4, verse 21 and verse 22. "Rejoice and be glad, O daughter of Edom, that dwellest in the land of us. The cup also shall pass through unto thee. Thou shalt be drunken and shalt make thyself naked. The punishment of thine iniquities is accomplished, O daughter of Zion. He will no more carry thee away into captivity."
No more carry us into captivity again. Right? That's so for white race. Right? Esau. Right? So the nation of Israel, they will be ruling. Right? They will come back to that ruling state.
"He will visit thine iniquity, O daughter of Edom. He will discover thy sins."
He will discover thy sins. Right?
Right? It says, Lamentation chapter 4, verse 22. "He will visit thy iniquity, O daughter of Edom."
He will visit thy iniquity. Edom. Right, all the atrocities that did to us, yeah. Slavery, right, feeding our young babes to alligator, putting them as they call it feet, bait, I mean.
"O daughter Edom, you will discover thy sins."
Discover thy sins.
right? This is Revelation chapter 13 and verse 9. It says, if a man have an ear, let him hear. He that leadeth into captivity shall go into captivity. He that killeth with a sword must be killed with a sword.
If a man have an ear, let him hear. He that leadeth into captivity must go into captivity. Right? Which is the so-called white man thing. We were under slavery, under all these other nations. Right? Esau. Moabites, right? All these other nations. So the scripture says, he that leadeth into captivity shall go into captivity. He that killeth with a sword must be killed with a sword.
Yeah. So called white man is being blessed with the sword, right? It is the modern day sword, is the gun, right? So he that killeth with the sword must be killed with the sword. So, so-called white man must go back into captivity, right?
Yeah, what we said. This is 2 Thessalonians 1 verse 6. It says, seeing it is a righteous thing with the Most High to recompense tribulation to them that trouble you.
Right? Hey, seeing it is a righteous thing with Yahweh, our Shite, to recompense tribulation and the ones that trouble you. And right now, who is the people that are troubling us in this current
nation? About your life.
Yeah. Who is the current ones who are troubling us right now?
It's the people who are humbug our life.
Who is that? What race are people like?
We people.
The so-called white race.
You're right.
Mainly the white man.
They're currently running this kingdom right now. Enemy number one.
Yeah. But as the brother said,
Edom trying to help us to go ahead in life.
But Edom is the number one, he's the enemy of the state.
That's right.
This is Psalms 44, verse 12. Thou sellest thy people for naught, and dost not increase thy wealth by their price. Thou makest us a reproach to our neighbors, a scorn and a derision to them that are wronged about us.
Right, so yeah, as brother saying, our enemies is these other nations that are wrong about us. But if you check it, the nation of Israel was dwelling on the, basically you could say the western part of the Middle East, going back there to the sea, right? And these other nations that was wrong about them, they had Tyrus and Zidon on the north, right? On the eastern side, they had Moab, they had Ammon, right? Assyria coming down. Right, so these other nations are wrong about us. They were our enemies. Right, so the Most High sell us into the hands of them for our disobedience. So these nations will, you know, they keep continuing oppressing us. Alright?
Brother was said just now, if any man have ears, right? If any man have understanding, right? Because the brother's spirit is a righteous thing. For the Most High recompense tribulation them that trouble me. Right? It's Joel chapter 3, verse 6. It said, the children also of Judah and the children of Jerusalem are being sold unto the Grecian, that he might remove them far from the border. So this going back to the Hamites and the Ishmaelites. Right? They are the two culprits who wrong us up and sell us to the so-called white man, right? He said, behold, I will rise them out of the place where he have sold them, and will return your recompense upon your own head. So the Most High gonna repay them for what they did, right? And I will sell your sons and your daughters into the hands of the children of Judah, and they shall sell them to the Sabians, to a people far off, for the Lord has spoken it. So we can take these either my children, or we can sell them to them at mics. We can trade them off, just like we do to us, you know. And let's risk our righteous judgment. Let's risk our righteous judgment.
Can.
This is Jeremiah chapter 25:14. For many nations and kings and great kings shall save themselves from them also, and I will recompense them according to their deeds and according to the works of their own hands.
Most I say he that stealeth a man and sell it in. You understand? And his pride in his hand shall surely be put to death. You understand?
This is Jeremiah 49 and verse 31. It says, arise and arise and get you up into the wealthy nation that dwelleth without care. Which is that wealthy nation that dwelleth without care, speaking about Babylon, which is America. Right? It says, say Yahweh, which have neither gates nor bars, which dwell alone. It says, and their commerce shall be a booty, and the multitude of their cattle the spoil. And I will scatter unto all winds them that are in the utmost corner, and I will bring thee calamity from all sides thereof, saith Yahweh. So the Most High, and I'm bringing destruction on Babylon from all corners, right?
And the Most High gonna make destruction on Babylon with them ICBM missiles. And America gonna be destroyed by nuclear fire. And utterly burned.
This is Isaiah 45, verse 1 and 2. He said, thus said Yahweh, Bashem El Shai, to his anointed to Cyrus, whose right hand I have holden, to subdue nations before him, and I will loose the loins of kings, to open before him the two lead gates, and the gate shall not be shut. I'll go before thee and make the crooked places straight. I'll break in pieces the gates of brass and cut in sunder the bars of iron. Right? Which goes back to America, he keeps up with the brother, basically red, a land that dwells without kings. Right? Because America, it goes back to that land. It's a free land, whatever the case is, they do whatever the hell they want because they see a man holding. All these other nations were afraid of them. But the Most High said that what he'll make the crooked path straight. You know what? Basically, he'll weaken the foundations of Babylon. Right now, all these other nations waking up and say, hey, we're strong. So they're coming against America. Right? Starting with Vladimir Putin, the king of the ancient land of Medes and the Persians, Gog and Magog. You understand? So when World War III, which is soon to come to place, America will then be weakened to a state where America had no say. And along this line where World War III going on, Yahweh Shai HaMashiach, the son of the living God, when I come back with the chariots from the east, destroy the world there. And then he'll come into Babylon according to Zechariah, land where the people first say, alright, and where they're holy captives. And Yahweh Shai HaMashiach, he's going to destroy America. You understand? So Yahweh Shai really and truly is that Cyrus. You understand? The anointed.
Real king of terrorism.
Right. Yeah?
Yeah, I don't know. Isaiah